Morning all. I am Raiha Sandalwala. I am working as a software engineer here. So I am here to talk about one of the projects that we are working on in IIT. The project is called National Virtual Library of India. So as the name suggests, it is something related to library, right? And it is a virtual library. And now why it is named this is because it has content mainly which is developed in India and which is about India. That's why it is called National Virtual Library of India. I'll quickly go through the contents. What was the vision behind it? What is NVLI? Its features, components, partners involved. There are various institutions who are involved in the project, and what are the benefits? I'll also quickly go through the portal. So why NVLI? What was the need of this system? So as we know that these days there is a need of digital content, we want that everything to be available digitally to us, online to us. And being from engineering background, we do not realize that how difficult it is for people who are pursuing arts to get all their information in one single portal. So that is why there was the need of such a portal. And this is an initiative of Ministry of Culture. So mainly the content is about the culture of India. It also has educational content, but most of the content as of now is related to the culture. So the vision is to empower people with right information and available on one platform. So now what is NVLI? It is a portal that has digital information. Like I said, it has resources which is developed in India and which is about India mainly. So since it is a library and it is a virtual library, you can understand the large volume of data that it can accommodate. That is why there is the need. And also since we come from different backgrounds, different languages, so there was a need to develop this into different languages. Not everybody is comfortable in English or in Hindi. So this has been developed in different languages as well. So these are some of the features of the portal. It has powerful search. Since it has, it is a library and it has a lot of data, a powerful search is a mandate. So it has a multilingual, cross-lingual search and full text search. Also, there's a feature for crowdsourcing for metadata. Now, you know what is metadata, right? It has data and all its features and where it has come from, all the data about data, what we call in layman language, right? So since it has data from a lot of variety of different institutes also and different backgrounds, what we did is we crowdsourced this particular feature. What we want people is to go through our website, see if the metadata about the data is fine. If they do not feel so, they can contribute to the metadata, to create metadata to correct that. So mainly these people are people who are subject matter experts or who have library science background. There is a feature of collaborative communities which is here being developed at IIT Bombay. Some of you might be working on this collaborative community. So the details I think will be shared in future presentations. Then localization of user interface, like I said, not everybody is comfortable with English and Hindi. So it is being developed in Marathi, Gujarati, Tamil, and a few more, which I don't know. Then folksonomy is about creating or organizing content as per the user. It is user-generated classification of content. Then ontology, big data trend analysis, and crawling of and harvesting of online resources. You might not be comfortable with some of the terms here, but I think you will gradually come to know, because some of you might be working on analytics. And I'll let you know what crawling is. Crawling is downloading data or extracting bulk data from web. This is and even harvesting is similar, but they are two different processes. The idea is same. We need to download bulk content through different processes. So while in crawling, we deal with huge data sets, and the advantage is we can collect data from different online resources and put them into one database or single cloud so that can be used later. Then mainly components, these are the three components of NVLI. Mainly it can be divided into three parts. One is cloud infrastructure. So like I said, since it is a digital library, it has cloud, it has data in terabytes and petabytes. So we here at IIT Bombay have set up a data center of around 3 petabytes for this project. Then this entire portal is developed by one of the partnering institutes of the project, which is CDAC Pune. So the complete design and development is done at CDAC, and data and metadata. So since it deals with data, we wanted data from a lot of different resources. So it has, I'll show you the data when we open the portal. It has rare books, manuscripts, then data from museums and different libraries, state and national libraries. So what we had to do is we had to collect data from them, digital data, and then curate that metadata. We had to, sometimes we had to create metadata for those digital assets, or if they were already there, then we had to curate metadata, clean that metadata. So the major chunk of this was done by IGNU. And we are still in process of collecting data from institutes. These are the three partners, IIT Bombay, CDAC Pune and IGNU Delhi. So like I said, here at IIT Bombay, we have set up a cloud of 3 petabytes. We also train library science background people to how to use our portal, and also training in Koha. So that how to curate metadata, how can they work with metadata. Then as I said, CDAC has mostly developed and designed this platform, and also they have participated in collecting data from different institutes. And IGNU has also been part of collecting metadata as well as curating them. Also, there is a particular standard which is to be followed. While if there is a PDF file or there is a video, what type of metadata do you want? Title is a must for everything, then author, then publisher, institute. So these are some of the metadata which are necessary for all types of data. So what IGNU did is IGNU came up with a standard metadata format, which is MARC21 and Dublin Core for these metadata. This is one of the things that is done by IGNU, and IGNU has also trained people in so that they can train library science people in other institutes so that they can contribute to us in curating metadata. So this is a picture of 3 petabyte cloud here at IIT Bombay. These are the racks, 4 racks, and these are the servers, storage. Now what are the benefits? So like I said, as of now I have not shown you the content of what is the content of NVLI portal, which we'll see now. So it has reliable free storage because it is here at our servers. Then it has global visibility. It is cost effective because everything is there on one single platform, a consolidated source of information, and tracking metadata modifications. This is more for people who are contributing to metadata. So that if they have done something to a particular asset, for example, there's a PDF file and they have contributed to that metadata. So if there is another, again, some change to that, they will get a notification to it. I'll just now quickly go through the portal. As of now, we have provided a limited access to the portal. We are in a phase of testing, and like I said, it deals with lot of content and metadata. So we have right now crowdsourced it to different people of library science departments in different institutions so that they can contribute back to us. Like I said, it is a limited user version. So this is how the portal looks like. And this is all the content. Like I said, it is a Ministry of Culture initiative, and mainly it has data which is related to culture of India, like some public records, union catalog, which we have received from National and State Library database, open repositories of different institutions, archaeological site museums, virtual museums, manuscripts are handwritten notes. Then NPTEL is this is one of the projects also in IIT, which it is mainly for engineering students, and we deliver courses of IIT professors to different engineering students, and we run these online courses basically, and they have assessment and grades and everything. So all those data is here. Then there are rare books, audiovisual archives, eminent personalities. I think I'll make a, so this is newspaper archives, Buddhist and Tibetan art. So it is taken from museums and different archaeological sites and also libraries. I'll just quickly make a search. I think, for example, I search Mahatma Gandhi. So these are all the results that I get, some 19,000 results from Buddhist and Tibetan art, from archaeological site museums, from ebook libraries. So this is how it looks like. Okay, for example, now if I click on national seminar on Mahatma Gandhi, so I get a video and I get all this metadata and some additional information. So this is how exhaustive it is. If you search anything, you get a lot of results, and from where it has come, everything. For example, a portrait of Mahatma Gandhi. So this is from where it has come from. This is a website called Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, which has also been developed at IIT. So it has been taken from there. So this is a huge place for people who are mostly into arts and science background, who are researchers. So we have tried and put all the content here at this portal. That's all. Thank you.